Hi friends, this is Devansh and in this video, I am going to tell you how you can fix can't connect to this network problem in Windows 10 or Windows 7 or Windows 8. So if you find this video useful, please like this video and subscribe to this channel. So let's start. So first method is we will try to troubleshoot the internet connection. So to troubleshoot, first go to the settings. In settings, go to update and security. And then search for the troubleshoot option at the left hand side. Now in troubleshoot, go to internet connection, click on it, and then click on run the troubleshooter. So it will start detecting the problems. Wait till it detecting. Now choose the troubleshoot my connection option. And here you can see I didn't get any issue or any error message come. But if you get any error message, try to click on resolve. So it will start, system will start resolving the issue. And later on, hopefully the error will get resolved. So this is the first method. If it doesn't work, then we will go for the second one. So now the second method is to try to reset the internet connection. For that, again, go to settings and this time go to networks and internet. In networks and internet, in the downside of this status, you will find the network reset option. Click on reset now and then click on yes. So once you click on yes option, the system will ask you to sign out. So just go to the start option and the power and click on restart. So this will restart your system and after that check that yes. So now the next method is try to change the DNS server. For that you have to go to the control panel and open the control panel. Now go to the network and internet. Here in network and sharing center, go to change adapter settings, which is at the left hand side. Now choose the Wi-Fi or the internet option and click on properties. Here click on this TCP IPv4 and go to the use the following DNS server address. Now give the preferred DNS server as 1.1.1.1 and alternate DNS server as 1.0.0.1 and click on OK. Once you click on OK, again go and now try to check that internet, you are able to connect to the internet or not. So this is the third method. Now if it doesn't work, go for the next one. Next method is go to the device manager and update or uninstall the driver. So firstly search device manager and inside that you have to search for the network adapters. Go to the network adapters and then click on the driver and click on update drive. Then click on search automatically for update driver. So it will start searching online for the drivers. Wait till it's searching. Then it will install the latest driver. You have to close it and then check if you are still getting the error or not. If you are still getting the error, then you have to again come here and right click and then choose for the uninstall device. Once you click on uninstall, it will ask for this permission. Click on uninstall and it will start installing the device. Once the installation is done, you will find a symbol like this in the downside. Once you click on it, there is no option for Wi-Fi or Ethernet. It means the device or driver is installed from your system. Now just go and restart your system. Go to start menu and click on restart. Once you restart your system, in the downside you will see that Wi-Fi option is back and you try to open your browser. So Google will again start opening in your system. This means that internet is working. So now use this method and check you are getting a positive result or not. So these are all the methods which can help you to fix this error. If you find this video useful, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and also please like this video. Thank you for watching.